Read a book with a young person, and you're helping them learn. But not just any book and any day. Today, we are joining together with a nationwide program that promotes reading the same book to children on the same day. Here to explain the mission behind Read for the Record are Emily Harris and Jamie Buswell with the Siouxland Libraries. They're among the millions of people across the United States who are helping jumpstart early learning for preschool children. Thank you both so much for coming in today.
Thank you for having us.
So, Emily, what exactly is Read for the Record?
It is a program started by Jumpstart. It's a national organization, and their mission is to have as many children ready for kindergarten as possible before they actually go to kindergarten. So one of the ways that they celebrate that is through Read for the Record Day.
Okay, so this is the 13th year for Siouxland Libraries.
Yes.
And how long have they, or this is the 13th year for the Read for the Record, but how long has Siouxland Libraries been a part of it?
Since 2011, so about 7 years. We started with just story times, and then from there we partnered with the Sioux Falls School District, and it's just grown from there. And so we've involved Sioux Falls Catholic Schools and Sioux Falls Lutheran, and it's become, and daycares has become what it is today.
So Jamie, how does this experience help a child's learning experience with reading?
Sure. Well, it helps make it fun. So of course kids are going to imitate what they see, and so if they see adults reading and having fun while they're doing it, then the kids are going to want to read too. So it's really just a way to help encourage kids to start reading and see that it is a lot of fun and it's not boring, but reading can be fun.
So who is this for?
Great question. So maybe Something Beautiful is a book that's all about a little girl and a painter who make this, you know, kind of boring, drab neighborhood into something that's really beautiful and colorful, and it's geared for kids that are kind of ages 4 through 8, but anyone could enjoy the colorful illustrations and the community message.
And so what record are we trying to break with this?
For Siouxland Libraries, I'm hoping to get 4,000 people. Last year we got 3,699, and with Jumpstart, they're trying to beat the previous year's record, which was 1.5 million. So we do what we can to help them get there.
So that's a lot of people. So how do you even keep track for sure how many people are participating in this?
I have a very big spreadsheet. So we give each child who participates a sticker, and I count how many stickers I give out. And we count it all up, and we send the number to Jumpstart, and then Jumpstart lets the world know if we broke the record.
So tell me a little bit more, Emily, how this program got started.
In Siouxland Libraries, or
just in general? Yeah, nationally.
Okay. So Jumpstart does it as a way to celebrate their mission. So it gives an exciting momentum to reading and literacy in general.
So how does doing this and picking a book that everyone will be doing, the same exact book, how does this help them with this and create that desire?
It makes it fun. It makes it a part of something bigger, that kids really love the Guinness Book of World Records books. And this way they get to be a part of something similar to that.
So Jamie, what do you hope happens after the event is completed?
Well, of course I hope we break the record. Yes. That would be awesome. But I also hope that kids just kind of, they gain a sense of love of reading and they continue to read afterwards and see that it is something that's really fun and exciting. So hopefully we continue to see them come see us at the library and check out books and participate in story times with us moving forward.
Have we been close in the past to breaking this record?
The Jumpstart record?
Yes.
Yes. So they've gotten as many as like almost 3 million in years past. So.
Oh my gosh, so that's a lot. So last year, how close was last year for breaking this record?
Not as close. We had 1.5 million read it nationally, so we need your guys' help.
So who in Keloland, Jamie, will be participating in this event?
Yeah, so we're going to have folks going all over to the Sioux Falls School District and also the Catholic schools and Lutheran schools and daycares. We'll have our mayor's going to be participating, police officers, firefighters, some Washington Pavilion folks, Minnehaha County commissioners, Wells Fargo employees, just lots of really awesome people who are going to help us break this record. But then you can also participate too. We're going to have a reading tomorrow, I guess today. I totally messed it up.
Today.
right
after this.
Yes, with Keloland Living. So at 2 o'clock, we're going to be reading that, and that'll be a ton of fun. But you can also come to any of our libraries and read there, too. So it'll be a blast. You just have to mark a tally on our poster boards, and we'll keep your number. We'll count you.
Yes.
Okay, so everyone in the community, if they just come into the library to get the book, they count as someone reading the book.
Yes, correct.
Okay. So, Jamie, what advice do you have when it comes to reading this book to people?
I would say have fun with it. You know, just really get into it. make some fun voices, look at the pictures, talk about the pictures, and then maybe do a fun activity afterwards. Try and make something beautiful in your home or in your neighborhood and see what you can do to kind of bring the book to life and make it part of you.
Should we be showing the illustrations as well, not just reading?
Correct, yeah. I think it's a lot of fun when you get to see the pictures and see the story in the picture form, and I think it really helps kiddos to kind of make that connection with the story.
All right, and so Emily, Jumpstart is the one who picks which book they'll use for the Read for the Record every single year, but have you noticed a common theme in the past years for what type of style reading it is or subject?
Usually it's just something that's really fun that kids will enjoy. Past years have included Llama Llama Red Pajama and Quackers, just really cute stories that kids will enjoy.
And after reading this, how can you take it one step further? Because you can sit and read the book, but then what can you do afterwards to enhance that?
You can do a coloring page. You can make your own mural on a piece of paper. Just keep reading other books that are similar. A librarian can always tell you, if you liked this book, we can find more like it for you. Just keep the momentum going.
All right, and so if I'm a grandparent or a parent, Jamie, where can I go to find a copy of this book to get if I want to read it?
Sure, you can come to any of our Siouxland Library branches and we'll have a copy available at our front desk. And then you can check it out, read it, and then also after the event, we'll continue to have the book circulating so you can always check it out if you missed it.
Are there only a certain amount of copies available at the libraries or do you have quite a few?
We have one at each branch.
Okay.
And also we'll have a Facebook video up on our Facebook page today. And if you go to the Jumpstart Read for the Record website, if you Google Jumpstart Read for the Record, they'll have a video of the book that you can watch and listen to also.
All right, and so since Gary and I are reading this right now too, after this segment, when we come back from the break, make sure you put two tallies for
yes.
Gary and I, because we are participating.
Absolutely, thank you so much.
All right, well thank you both for coming in today.
Thank you. Yeah.